Well, praise the Lord. Welcome to New Day Christian Center. And we'd like to welcome everyone out that's watching the service on the internet. God bless you. You're going to be blessed today. And it is my prayer for you right now that the Spirit of God be released exactly where you're at, to touch your hearts, to heal your bodies, to bring comfort to your soul, peace to your hearts, and wisdom to your mind. Let it be done today, Father, through your word. Touch and heal and bless all over the world in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. You can be seated.
Amen.
I'd like to minister for a few minutes this morning. I'm not going to get very profound, but it's something that's been on my heart the last few weeks. And we're going to look at the Word of God concerning sickness and healing. Amen?
Amen.
But for the people out on the internet, I'd like to encourage you. These are prayer requests that come in from all over the area. People ask Pastor TC and the church here at New Day Christian Center and the ministry staff to pray for their loved ones. All kinds of prayer requests. I just brought a few, and I'd like to share with you. Also, go to our website, NDCC with TC, and you can watch the services on the internet. And right there on our site, there's a P.O. box that you can write to, and we will send you one of these prayer clauses. Now, folks, I'm not into trinkets. I'm not into a bunch of trinkets and nonsense, and please, I'm not trying to judge anybody. There's all kinds of biblical things that you can receive and you can use as a point of contact. And what this prayer cloth is as if Pastor or Pastor Darlene or one of the assistant ministers here, one of these great men of God, was to take you by the hand and pray and release their faith to heaven with you. And release their anointing that God's placed in their life onto your body. That their hands, as doctrinally stated in the Bible, that you shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. So this point, this first off is a point of contact, that we can't be there personally, but according to Acts chapter 19, 11 and 12, where God worked special miracles through Paul, that they took handkerchiefs and aprons and gave them to the sick and they were healed. And devils left their body. And that's just as real now as it's ever been. God still does mighty signs and wonders through strange and different ways now as he ever has. It's still in the Bible to anoint with oil and the prayer of faith will heal the sick. Jesus said, lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. The Bible says that the miracle presence of the blood of Jesus and the Spirit of God can literally go into a cloth and the power of God stay with that cloth until it gets to the sick body. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Isn't that amazing?
Amen.
Look at somebody doing with God all things are possible.
With God all things are possible.
So go to that website, New Day Christian Center with TC, NDCC with TC. I'm not going to tell you who thought of that. And request one of these absolutely free, but you have to request it. You can also write to our P.O. box there on the internet. It's posted. And we'll send you one of these prayer cloths. Maybe there's sickness in your body and you need a way of just reaching out and having a place. You need to feel that touch of faith from us. And then the healing power of God will come into your body or into the body of a loved one. Amen. The folks, I'm telling you these were wonderful miracles already. Prayer requests that come in, if you'll write to the P.O. box, list your prayer request when you ask for a prayer cloth, then we'll transfer it to one of these prayer request slips, and it'll be brought here, and we anoint these prayer requests with oil. We anoint them with oil and pray the prayer of faith and intercession over each and every one of them every single day. You will be lifted to the Lord. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now I want to just read a couple. I'm not going to, and for you to right in. We're not gonna put your name on the internet. We're not gonna embarrass you. Because some of these are very, very serious prayer requests. We're here to be a blessing. God wants you well. Say it with me. God wants you well. Amen. Here's Robert. Was in the hospital with stomach problems, diabetes. And we write in big red letters, praise the Lord, when they're healed and released. Praise report there. Sister Debbie had severe, they didn't think she was going to live. Her heart was completely failing. Big red letters, praise the Lord, she's been released from the hospital. Healed. Here's another one. Unknown weight loss. Marital problems. Wants to get back with God. Praise the Lord. Back with God. Marriage back together. Back with the wife. Hallelujah. God still does miracles. Here's another one. Sent to the hospital with a possible stroke. Emergency prayer request. Praise the Lord. Released. The doctors couldn't find anything wrong. Hallelujah. Somebody say, God is good.
God is good.
Now here's one that was called in to me personally, because this gentleman knows me, and he called in, and make a long story short, he had been in a car wreck with his family. And he's a brother, he's a believer in the Lord, and he knows the power of prayer. And he called this great church, and he called and spoke with me, and he said, I'm being sued, that the man that ran into my car, almost killed me and my family, tried to turn it around. You know how Satan will try to turn things around. He's the twister. He'll do the wrong thing and then twist it around and put it on you. Amen? And this man was turning it around, trying to make it look like in court that this brother in the Lord had caused the wreck. And this was tied up in court for over a year. And he called in and he said, Pastor, I'm becoming weak. My faith is weak. The devil's trying to wear me down. And he'll do that. That's why you got to stand firm. Got to stand fast in the Lord. Satan will push. And if you don't give up ground and you stand, having done all to stand therefore in the faith of the Lord, Satan will flee from you. He wrote in, after sending in this prayer request, great big praise the Lord, last month, the lawyer called his lawyer and said, we're dropping pursuit of the case. They didn't even go to court. Tied him up for a year, and when it came right down to it, Satan broke and ran. And it was completely released in court. Hallelujah. God can turn the court around. God can turn your body around. God can send Satan fleeing. And God can cause cancer, diabetes, heart problems. He can give you a new heart. Cleanse your blood of diabetes. Cleanse your blood of AIDS. Cleanse your body of hepatitis. Over and over and over again, the miracle love of God flowing through simple prayer cloths, simple believers agreeing with you for your need to a God that sees you, loves you, and will move for you. Here's another one. Brother Bill sent to the hospital with heart problems and diabetes. Diabetes, diabetes, diabetes. Why? Because this world system puts so many chemicals and such junk in food, it's almost impossible to eat healthy. So you better eat in faith. Why it says, pray over your food, and God will sanctify your food and make it good for your body. You have to pray over your food. The plates that are sitting in front of you in restaurants, what you buy at the store is already pre-programmed by hell with chemicals to destroy the chromosomes and the cells of your body and bring your natural ability for health down to where Satan can come in and turn that to cancer, diabetes, and all manner of evil. You've got to pray. If you've already got diabetes, write to us. God's still healing, delivering, miracle-working God over and over again. Big red letters, released from the hospital. Blood, normal, heart, couldn't find anything wrong with it. They said they thought it was stress. Hallelujah. Here's another one. Family problems, wrote in on the verge of divorce. Lift him up before the Lord. Big red letters, praise the Lord. God answered back together. Over and over.